There was a landmark development in the history, language and literature of Kerala in the 17th century. That was actually the period when some of the highly evolved art forms developed in the Kerala society. And the reason why those art forms came into being mainly depends upon the translation of the great Indian epics Ramayana, Mahabharata and Bhagavata by none other than Tunjatha Ramanujan Ezhuthachan. In fact, Ezhuthachan's translation of the great Indian epics paved the way for the language identity inherent to Kerala society. Till then, whatever the scholars say, whatever the critics say, there could be difference of opinion, but at the same time, in a certain sense, we can conclude that the evolution of the language Malayalam that became a reality, especially in the literary sense, only when Tunjatha Ramanujan Ezhuthachan translated the great Indian epics, and these translations became immensely popular among the middle class Kerala society. And as a reflection of this landmark development in language, in the 17th century, just a century afterwards, in the 17th century, Krishnaattam, the dance of Lord Krishna, the story of Lord Krishna executed in dance, executing the life story of Lord Krishna. This became an art form, and this was evolved in Calicut by the Zamorin who wrote the play Krishna Geethi. This play was penned by Manaveda, who didn't actually expect that this would become an art form. His writings would be presented in the form of an art form in which Lord Krishna's incarnation till his final redemption. The whole stories, all the major stories that took place in the life of Krishna got visualized in Krishnaattam. And Krishnaattam basically is a dance form. We cannot treat Krishnaattam as a theatre tradition, although there are a few theatrical elements when some of the episodes in Krishnaattam are performed. And Krishnaattam became immensely popular to go with the historical notes presented by the late historian K.P.S. Menon. Krishnaattam became immensely popular in the Malabar area, in North Kerala, especially in Calicut and the surroundings. But for some reasons, Krishnaattam could not become popular in Central Kerala or in South Kerala, or even in deep North Kerala. The reason why Krishnaattam could not become popular is something to be explored. I don't think that art historians, art scholars have explored the reasons why Krishnaattam became not so popular in the other regions of Kerala. Whatever it is, in course of time, this art form which was developed, which was evolved in the 17th century, got confined to the Guruvayur temple. So Krishnaattam as a dance tradition now exists only in the Guruvayur Devaswam, where there is a kalari, there is a training center for Krishnaattam, and there is also performance. And the performance mostly is confined to offerings in the Guruvayur temple to Lord Guruvayurappa, to Lord Krishna. So when the devotees would like to fulfill some of their needs, they would like to have some of their ambitions fulfilled or realized, they would pray to Lord Guruvayurappa in front of the deity, and they would say that we would offer one Krishnaattam play to you. So then one of the stories will be performed. In that way, almost every day Krishnaattam is performed in the Guruvayur temple. These are all the results of the prayers of the devotees. And what happened was that since this dance form got restricted to Guruvayur Devaswam and the Guruvayur temple, it didn't reach the people so much. Only the devotees watched the Krishnatam performances. Krishnatam didn't have the fortune to go outside the precincts of the temple and get into the public sphere and win the appreciation of the general audience, which this particular luck actually came to Kathakali, the classical dance drama. Kathakali, the dance of which is indebted to Krishnatam. Kathakali is a highly eclectic dance theatre tradition. It imbibed many of the techniques of acting, dancing and music from the surviving classical performing arts. So for the dance part, Kathakali owes a lot to Krishnatam. For the theatre, it owes a lot to Kudiyattam, the traditional Sanskrit theatre. For music, the temple music tradition, both the vocal and the instrumental music. And Krishnatam became, in fact, a source material for Kathakali to enrich its dance. Other than that, Krishnatam didn't have an outreach in the Kerala society. It just got confined to the Guruvayur temple, although it does have so many beautiful movements. Like in the episode of Rasalila, there is a segment called Mullappu Chuttal that is covering the body with jasmine flowers. And this Mullappu Chuttal has so much of elegant movements, graceful movements, which I am sure Mohiniyattam dancers can take, and they can adopt these movements into their dance form. So in this way, Krishnatam, which should have gotten lots and lots of publicity outside Guruvayur and outside Calicut, unfortunately got restricted to these areas, first in Calicut and later on in Guruvayur. It ended up there, but still that art form survives, mainly because it is considered as a ritual too. It's not only a performance tradition, but it is a ritual tradition as well. As long as the ritual element of an art form is preserved, is something that is considered mandatory, that art form is sure to survive. If that ritual element was not there, think of a situation, Krishnatam didn't have this ritual component. Had that been the case, Krishnatam, the art form, would not have survived. But fortunately, there are some performers, there were great performers in the past who all came from a place called Kuthanur in Palghat, in eastern Palghat. Most of the performers came from Kuthanur, that area. But now performers are coming from other places also. Somehow the art form survives, but its aesthetics, from the aesthetic angle, from the aesthetic point of view, Krishnatam doesn't seem to have lots to offer, mainly because it doesn't have interaction with the people, with the spectators. That makes a lot of sense. Thank you.